What's up guys, it's Maverick here and welcome to the review of the new Arma 2 DLC, Army of the Czech Republic. I'm gonna introduce you guys to the units and vehicles that come with this new downloadable content. And then I'm gonna show you real quick the different maps, and I'm just gonna say a word or two about the single player and the multiplayer. So you get like two unit types, which are special forces and regular army, and both of those categories come with like desert and woodland camo. So what you see here are the woodland special forces. So pretty cool gear and camo suits and stuff. They carry some new weapons. Not all of them are new, but yeah, but you get quite a few new weapons, and yeah, that looks pretty sweet. So those are woodland special forces. Here you see the desert version, slightly different with the gear and equipment. So that's special forces, and then you get like the regular army. They look pretty similar, so they have the same woodland camo, obviously. Some of the same weapons, but mostly like the headgear is different, so the helmets and stuff. But other than that, they look pretty much the same. And then over here you get the same thing for like the regular army. With the
How
desert camo suit. Alright, that's pretty much it for the infantry already. Let's get over to the vehicles. You get the like the standard vehicle categories. So you get like cars, so transport vehicles, light armor, heavy armor, support vehicles such as ammunition, repair and fuel trucks. Medical vehicles, and then obviously some aircraft. So what you see here is a first aid or a medical Land Rover version. Here is like an ammo truck, which is a new model. Standard transport truck, the desert camo. Here transport truck with a machine gun on top with the woodland camo. And those vehicles here, those are dingoes. They look pretty cool. So, slightly armored troop carriers. They're coming two versions, one with a machine gun, one with a grenade launcher on top. And then the same thing with the woodland camo. This over here is the Pandur APC. That's pretty cool. So troop transporter as well. You get a pretty big machine gun. I think it's like a 20mm or so, I'm not sure. With HE and AT rounds and a coaxial machine gun. The main battle tank here is T-72. Slightly adapted model as well. Some reactive armor and stuff. Pretty cool. And this here is the artillery vehicle. So like a an MLRS, so a multiple launch rocket system. And yeah, that's the new content, so the new vehicles. And there come some more vehicles that we have already seen from previous DLCs or like the original games. They just come with some with a new camo reskin, desert woodland. There's also units like with Humvees, but just the Czech soldiers in it. And here you see like a Land Rover with the Czech skin. So that's so for the ground vehicles. You get some chats. This here is the Albatross. It's, yeah, like the main combat aircraft as far as I can tell, you get air-to-ground missiles, air-to-air missiles, and a machine gun. This is like a slightly different version, different skin, and this one has a machine gun and some quite a few non-guided rockets. And this over here is pretty much like a training aircraft, if you ask me, because this jet has no weapons whatsoever, not even a machine gun. Here's it. You see the Hind gunship. Also, just a reskin. Other than that, it's the same like the one from the Pakistani army or so. And here you get the transport helicopter. And this one is the armed version with almost 200 unguided rockets. And that's pretty much it for the content, unit and vehicle wise, that comes with this DLC. So let's have a look at the maps. Okay, yeah, you get like three different maps that come with this download. The first one is Bukovina, and this is pretty much just an airfield. So it's the one you've just seen in the vehicle and in unit display. And if you ask me, it's pretty much just a cutout of Chernarus, of like the main airfield at Chernarus, with minor changes with the buildings and stuff and some terrain changes. And yeah, it's just a cutout. So you see here the border of this map. It's like, I don't know, 3 on 3 or 5 on 5 clicks or so. So it's pretty small. And yeah, you get the big airfield in the center, and then some smaller towns around. And yeah, that's already it. Just a quick overflight. You see here the terrain, some roads, some smaller cities, and like compounds, some meadows, and yeah, a lot of forests. So pretty much generous, if you ask me. Then here in the center you get the airfield, and if you fly over that to the other side, there's another like a little bit bigger city, and yeah, that's already it. It's kind of a shame because you got the big airfield, but it's not really a flight map or a flying map because it's so damn small. The second map that comes with the download is Takistan cutout version. So it's the Takistan map, but just like a part of it. It's kind of hard to estimate how big it is. It's bigger than the other one with the airfield. But if you remember the Zarishang Pass area, this is like pretty much the lower left side of the whole Takistan map. So it's probably like a quarter. Yeah, a quarter or so of the Takistan map. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, I haven't really checked it out yet, but I'm pretty sure it's like the exact same thing with the buildings and all, but it's just a cutout version. So we're gonna do it an overflight anyways. Yeah, so Takistan terrain, desert terrain obviously, and you get here those cities, villages, and then on the right you get the passes. Some more valley area, some more cities, buildings, compounds, a lot of stuff to clear. And then over here, like the map is, it's the border of the map, so you see no more trees and stuff. It's just like the rough terrain. So yeah, it's just a Takistan cutout. Don't really see the point of this, but I'm not here to judge. Alright, the last map that you get like from the beginning as well is Bistrica. This is also more or less a Chernarus type of map, but it's completely new, so it's not like a cutout or just an overworked version of a former map. This is completely new, and it's pretty big too, so I don't know, maybe 10 or 10 clicks or so. And you get here on the southern area, you get the river, where there are two bigger cities with harbor areas and stuff. That's pretty cool, and then the further north you go, the more like wooden area and hill areas and stuff you get. Roads, some smaller compounds, some castles. It's nothing like extremely special or so. But it's a wooden terrain, so make sure your graphic cards is able to run this with a good performance. So let's go to the overfly. Alright, so what you see here is the first bigger city. Just actually, yeah, it's really big. So you can do some nice urban combat and stuff. You get the river area, and then if you would follow the river, we would come to the other bigger city there in the south. But we're gonna head north, and you see here a lot of fucking trees. And then you get some like smaller compounds here, smaller villages, single buildings. Yeah, a lot of stuff to see. And a road system that is connecting everything. Some valleys, some hills, some more villages. And yeah, we're already at the other side of the map. And it pretty much all looks the same. Just as generous. Head down to the river again. This is pretty cool. I love this camera script. And this is the second big city down at the river. Alright. So that's the third map. Okay, last but not least, the campaign and missions that come with this DLC. There's a single player campaign which is called Silver Line. I can't tell you how big it is because I have just played the first mission at the beginning of the second. So I have no idea how long it's gonna go on, but I estimate it's about the same as with the PMC or the British Armed Forces add-on, so a few single player missions. There's no multiplayer content or multiplayer missions ready, but obviously you can create them yourself using the vehicles and units from this DLC. But there's nothing preset coming with the download. So to sum the whole thing up, I was very suspicious at the beginning why they would release another DLC like pretty short before Arma 3 is supposed to be released, but I'm not really counting on the Arma 3 release this fall. I'm expecting that they're gonna postpone it for another few months, but I hope for the best, obviously. But it's kind of suspicious that they bring a DLC right now a couple of months before the actual release, so we'll see what happens. You get not too much new stuff with this download. You get some new units, pretty much reskins, some new weapons, some new vehicles, one actually really new map, but it's just $12, so I figured what the hell, and I bought it anyway. So if you want it, check it out or buy it at the BIS store and knock yourself out with it. Otherwise, just wait and wait for Arma 3. So thanks for watching, and if you got it, feel free to leave a comment about what you think, if you're happy with this download, or what you think about the Arma 3 release. Is it gonna be released in fall or not? And feel free to share your opinion about the whole thing. So thanks, and I'll catch you guys soon. I'm Rikka.